Welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Lalita and today in this video I am going to discuss about AF oscillator and its order code is 2223UN0175.48. Basically this AF oscillator is used in the laboratories.
Now I am going to showing you the accessory which we need for making the wall setup of AF oscillator. So when we need G clamp, C clamp, weds, wet holder, spring holder, spring, SS rods, pendulum rod A and pendulum rod B, data equation unit, power supplier and magnetic sensors. So now I am going to show you that how we will make the connection of AF oscillator. So let's start. So first of all, we will mount the G clamp into the state table. With the help of this screw, we will tighten similarly, we will connect another G clamp. After that, we will put the SS rods into the G clamp. And we will tighten it with the help of this screw. Similarly, we will connect another SS rod. Both the SS rod should be at same height. We will connect the C clamps into the SS rods and tighten the screw. Similarly, we will connect another C clamp into the SS rod. Both the C clamp should be at same height. After that, we will fix the pendulum rod A into the pendulum rod B. And we will connect an spring holder into this pendulum rod A. After that, we will connect the weds into the
After that, we will connect the magnetic sensor to the data equation unit. We will connect it here, like that. And similarly, we will connect another magnetic sensor. And this magnetic sensor will connect to the C clamp. Into the C clamp, one hole is given where we will connect it. Similarly, we will connect another one. And at last, we will connect the adapter to the data equation unit. So like that, we can make the AF oscillator setup. Now we will start the first number experiment to study of two normal mode of coupled oscillator and record the oscillations to determine the time period in both the in phase T0 and out of phase T1. So let's start. First of all, I will move the pendulum A in any direction, and before moving the pendulum A in any direction, I will play the start button of data equation unit. In the data equation unit, two switch are given, stop switch and start switch. So I will start to move pendulum A and will calculate the 20 oscillations. So let's start. Twenty oscillations has been done and I have played stop switch. Now we will calculate the time period of one oscillation by dividing the total time period by 20. Here you can see on the display of data equation unit the total time period, and for calculating the one oscillation period you can divide the total time period by 20. And you also can see the bar graph. As S2 is moving, the bar graph of S2 is showing on the display. Now we will continue the first number experiment and will connect the spring to spring holders. And after connecting the spring holders, I will move both the pendulums in same direction. After moving the pendulums, both the pendulums should be moved in same direction. You can see both the pendulums are moving in same direction. Now by the data equation unit we will see the bar graph.
You can see the bar graph on the display.
Now we will continue the experiment by helping the software. So first of all, I will connect the data equation unit to the PC with the help of this cable. After connecting, I will move both the pendulums in same direction and I will measure the waveforms through the software. So let's start. I will move both the pendulums and we will measure the waveforms with the help of software.
Now we will continue the experiment and we will download the software. The link of the software we will provide you in the description, from where you can download the software. And for understand the procedure of installation, you can go through the lab manuals. So let's start. This is the software from where we will get the waveforms. So first of all, I will
press the connect and will press OK. Then I will set the time 60 seconds and choose S1 and S2 option to record the oscillations of both pendulums using S1 and S2 sensor. I have choose already, and adjust the position of S1 and S2 at upward and downward direction respectively. After that, oscillate the both pendulums and click on the plot button. The individual oscillations of both the pendulums are being recorded simultaneously on your computer screen, you can see. After completing the graph, you can measure the time period of each pendulum individually. You can see the graph has been completed. Now we will get the readings from here. You can see the value of bar graph 1 is approx 18.44. I will put this value in reading 1 box. Similarly, I will measure the value of coordination of both the point and will insert the value of x coordination of pick in the reading 2 dialog box. It is approx 15.11. Now I will put the number of complete oscillations. The complete number of oscillations is 23, and I will press the calculate. You can see here the time interval is 3.33 seconds and time period is approx 0.14 second and frequency is 7.1429 hertz. Similarly, calculate the time period of second pendulum, that is follows the step, and if the time period of both the pendulums is same, coupled both the pendulums with the coupling spring such that the hooks of spring are dead the third red mark, that is 40 cm from the suspending point. Now we will connect the spring and will measure the time period.
Now we will continue the experiment and will connect the spring to both the pendulums. After connecting the spring, I will move both the pendulums in same direction and will measure the waveforms through the software. Now we will measure the waveforms.
Now we will start the second number experiment to record the oscillations of a coupled pendulum at the maximum beat amplitude and determine the time period of the oscillations TC as well as the beat time period TB, and compare the experimental value of time period with the values calculated from intrinsic period T0 and T1. So let's start. I will move one of pendulum in any one direction and the energy of pendulum A will be transferred. transmit into the pendulum B. And for determining the B time period, I will press the start button and will measure the timing and will count the oscillations. When it comes into the rest position, I will play the stop button. And I will calculate the total number of oscillations of pendulum B. It has been come into the rest position, so I will play the stop button. So the total time taken by the pendulum B to come to rest position is called time B time period, TB. And now we will divide the total time taken by the number of oscillations. It will give you the value of coupled time period. Now with the help of this formula, you can get all the values.
Now we will start the second number experiment with the help of software. So we will follow the same procedure as we did in first number experiment. So I will first of all connect it and we will set the time between 120 to 180 and we will select the S1 and S2 and I will move the pendulum A and will play the plot. You can see the graph on the computer screen. After completing the graph, we will get the reading 1 and reading 2. Seconds remaining. The bar graph has been completed. Now we will get the values of coordinations. It is approx 40.78. And I will put this value into reading 1 box. Similarly, I will get the value from here, which is approx 27.89. And I will put the number of complete oscillations, which is 50. And I will press the calculate. You can see the total time interval is 12.49 seconds and time period is 0.25 and frequency is 4 hertz.
So that's all the demonstration. which is given by me. If you have any query related to this apparatus, you can go through the link which is given in the description. And if you want to know more about this apparatus, you can go through the lab manuals. Thanks for watching this video. If you like it, please like, share and subscribe our channel. Thank you.